So what do we have here? We have basically an armor seekers. There's also a blinding beam, a sand sower, and that's about it. Let's see, target player. So we can get bridge from below into our graveyard by using thieving sprite on ourselves, or by dredging stinkweed imp. But that's not very realistic, so we're just gonna take the armor seekers. Hopefully something wheels. Oh look, a murderous red cap. That's pretty good. There's also avian changeling, but murderous red cap is quite a nice creature. Really awesome with Death Knight, Warren Pilfers, Revel Arc, Otherworldly Journey. And the changeling is gonna be good, but murderous red cap is a little bit better. And by that I mean it's pretty annoying to play against most times, so we're gonna snag that up. It's good against a fair number of archetypes. And we can hide this Kataki. And it looks like we'll probably be playing the rest of this. You can definitely see the rune stalactite just because we've got the pepper smoke, the two great hearts, and that'll overlap a lot with some of the rest of the cards that we've got. So we only need a few more cards before we need to submit. And it looks like we have a Blight Speaker or a Marsh Flitter. Jeez. There's also Blinding Beam, but this is actually pretty tough, I think. We have three Rebel Searchers right now, and I kind of want to just take Marsh Flitter, just because it is a pretty good flyer, but Blight Speaker is just so nice sometimes, just being able to have that redundancy in late game. I think I'm going to stick with the Blight Speaker, just because we really need to focus on the Rebels, and this guy is good, but at the same time, I want to make sure that our Rebel chain is not disrupted, and so I think this is probably the last Rebel that we need, the Rebel Searcher. Oh, what do we have here? Let's take a look at this guy. Prowls with Rogues or Goblins, and then when it hits them, we get to exile three cards, so that would be Avian Changeling, or let's see, any of the Avian Changelings. Yeah, doesn't seem like it's that bad. We could also take the Tidehall Scholar. That's kind of close. I think that's the pick is between those two. I'm not really too interested in veteran armor. And I'm just gonna go with the Tidehall Scholar just because it has more of an impact on what's going on in the current game, whereas the Earwig Squad gets better as the game progresses, and if games go long and players are more likely to draw a lot of their deck, then I would rather have the Earwig Squad, but I'd rather have the Tidehall Scholar otherwise. This pack doesn't really have too much for us except for our veteran armor. I'm not really interested in playing Deep Cavern Imp, so we can hide that. And so we could take a second Thieving Sprite, hate Ephemeron, but I'm just going to take this veteran armor in case we play against a bunch of pepper smokes. And it looks like we don't have too much here. We could take a Warren Rooting, which is not really that great. Take a Raven's Crime. We already have one, but when we side them in, we're probably going to want to draw one very quickly, so I can definitely see having a second one. Yeah, there's another Blight Speaker, but I'm not going to be too disappointed with taking another one of these. I'm not interested in another Great Heart. And here we can take Stir the Pride, I suppose. This thing is pretty sweet. +2/+2, and all of these other creatures are sort of overlapping in what we have, so Stir the Pride is pretty unique. And we can take a Blinding Beam now. And another Warm Pilferers. It's going to be better than Festering Goblin overall. So we actually have a bit of a decision to make. We have the sort of Kithkin Great Hearts and the Rune Stalactite, along with the three Avian Changelings and the Ivory Giant. And that's going to be competing with the last few slots in the deck. Second Blinding Beam versus Gleam. I'm going to take Gleam. I think that's a bit better with some cards like Wrathy Trapper and Blight Speaker. It does a little bit more overall. And Thysis. So yeah, I think we may end up cutting the Pepper Smoke, the Rune Stalactite, and then the two great hearts in favor of just cards that are individually more solid than that entire package. Because what can end up happening a lot is you may draw one or two of those cards, but if those get disrupted, then you're left with pretty underpowered cards as a result. And so by playing more cards that are more powerful individually, you're not going to run into that nearly as much. So if we hide those, hide the Pepper Smoke, which we can board in, hide the two Great Hearts, we're left with 26, which we can also hide. Maybe we don't necessarily need to play the Veteran Armor. And here we can take a Mine Funeral and a Partic Dragon. So overall, pretty happy with how this draft went. There were a few different options that we had initially. We could have been a bit more forceful with five color green, and it's unclear as to how open it would have been for pack two, but what I'm gonna do now is lay out this, what we have, and then get back to you. Alrighty, so we've got 30 spells right here, which means we're probably gonna have to cut a few of those. So 20 of them are creatures. Let's take a look at the bad ones. We've got five Rebel Searchers, three Blight Speakers, and two Amber Scouts. And also other Rebels that we have. We've got one Wrathy Trapper, which is unfortunate, actually. Just really wanted to see more of those. So we don't really have too many controlling elements, but we've got some beatdown cards, like one Amber Seekers and three Avian Changelings. So the way I see these games playing out is that they're not going to be, they're going to be a bit more combat in, focused than just some of the other games that will take place with different Rebel decks, because since we don't have Saltfield Recluse and Wrathy Trapper, it's not going to be like we're just attacking with one creature every time. We're most likely going to be playing games where there's a ton of attacking and blocking on both sides. So that's going to increase the value of cards like Warren Pilferers and Death Denied. So what I want to do is, let's see, that'll increase the how good Great Heart is, but I'm not going to, since a lot of trading is going on, I don't really want to have to rely on these guys, because it's more likely that we're going to get blown out by something like Glacial Ray when our Avian Changeling gets killed and suddenly our Great Heart isn't so great, and rely on more of the just the individual cards. So looking at this, we're down to 26 cards, which leaves stuff like Veteran Armor, basically Veteran Armor and Thysis and Blinding Beam and Stir the Pride. I can definitely see Gleam being a little bit better, just because we've got three Blight Speakers and a Wrathy Trapper. But Stir the Pride is definitely packs more of a punch. So I think initially I'm going to try and run Stir the Pride. Might be able to feed the Gleam in, but let's see what happens when we take out this Veteran Armor. And looking at the rest of our cards, the Ivory Giant isn't nearly as impressive, just because half of our creatures are white now. So if we cut that down 24, so theoretically we could cut something like Thysis and then call it a day. Or we can cut one of these Warren Pilferers, but I think I want to stick with both Pilferers and the Death Knight and get rid of the Thysis. Generally not a fan of Thysis, just because it's slow, hard to set up. So we'll go ahead and cut this for now. And there may be something that we want to run over the, or put the Veteran Armor back in, but I don't want to cut any of these spells, I think, and the rest of these creatures just look too good. So I think that's all I'm going to go with. These Warren Pilferers are a little out of place, because we're not blocking with Amber Seekers or Avian Changelings, Blight Speakers, Wrathy Trappers. So I can definitely see these being exchanged for something. We could put the Great Hearts back in, and that would lower the curve a bit better, although That would definitely make it less likely that we're able to grind out games like we normally would. So I think I'm actually gonna start it like this, and just see where that goes. We could put in the two great hearts in the stalactite. Run, but I want to run 17 lands, so we'd have to cut something like Stir the Pride or Gleam. For now, I think I'm gonna try this and see what happens. So let's go ahead and add land. Magic Online doesn't want us to play any mountains, or I don't. But we're gonna go ahead with 9, 7, 9, 9, 8. Yeah, that'll work out better. So what I'm gonna do is submit this and then get started with round one, and I'll see you then.